In this video, we'll take a look at how job scheduling works using Node.js. Before moving on to job scheduling, we first need to know what a cron job is. So a cron job is a scheduling program that executes tasks at specific intervals. These jobs are mostly used to automate repetitive tasks so that engineers could work on more important business-oriented issues. For instance, say you're working at Netflix and you have users whose accounts have an expiry date. You can schedule a cron job to deactivate accounts based on this date. Sending out daily newsletter emails is also a very popular use case when it comes to cron jobs. If you're working at a place where you have to manage huge chunks of data for reporting purposes or even graphical analysis, they can be regularly updated with a cron job since they don't really need to be real-time. So metrics like page hits, or user details like their age, gender, or location can be stored in a table which will be updated in regular intervals using a cron job. Now there's multiple ways to implement this in Node.js. There's actually an article that explains differences between the top job scheduling libraries and which one you should choose based on your application needs. I'll be using Brie for this particular application. Even though it's relatively new, it's feature-packed and you can also run this in the browser if you want to. I also like the overall documentation, and the person who's maintaining this library has been part of other big Node projects, so the developer experience can also be expected to be decent. Brie also uses worker threads behind the scenes to create these cron jobs, which is great because then it won't block the main thread. So the first thing that we'll do is create a Node project. This will create a package.json file. Now we can add our dependencies. So for this application, we need a couple of dependencies. The first one is Express, obviously. And the second one will be Brie. I have NodeMon installed in my system globally, so I don't need to install it again. But if you want NodeMon in your application, you can install it in your dev dependencies. So once this is done, we can add a server file. And inside this file, I'll just add some Express boilerplate code. Now, once this is done, we can move on to scheduling a job. So first, we'll need to import Brie in our application. In order to use Brie, we need to create an instance first. Inside this, we have a lot of properties that we can pass in. The most important one will be jobs. This is an array of jobs that will run at a specific time interval. In order to run these jobs, we actually need to create these jobs somewhere first. So inside our project directory, we'll just create a jobs folder. And inside this folder, we can pass in different kinds of jobs that will do some particular tasks. So for now, I'll just have a dummy job, which will be a typical JavaScript file. And inside this, I'll just have a console log statement that returns job executed. So now I can pass in this dummy job as a string, or I can pass in an object with some additional properties for this job. So I personally prefer to pass in an object because this gives us more flexibility, and you can add in extra options which you can't in case of a simple string. So here I need to pass in the name of the job, which is dummy. I can pass in interval. So for the time being, I'll just pass in 5 seconds, which is also going to be a string. I can also pass in timeout, which is the amount of time after which the job will start executing. So I'll keep timeout also to 5 seconds. Can see a few extra properties here. So since Brie uses worker threads behind the scenes, you can actually close the worker after a particular time period manually. Cron takes in a cron value instead of an interval, so we'll take a look at that later. Cron validate is used to validate these cron expressions that we pass inside this cron key. You can also pass in specific dates instead of intervals. These jobs will be run in separate workers, so you can pass in metadata to individual workers or individual jobs and then use them for a specific use case. The path property is basically the path for that job inside the jobs folder. So if you're not using this jobs folder as a container for all your jobs, which basically means that your folder structure is different, you can pass in that path instead. And you can also pass in some extra data inside this worker property. So we have this Bree instance now. We can just simply use Bree start to execute our jobs. If I now save this and run this using NodeMon, after a few seconds, you should ideally see a console log, which is basically this. Yeah, as you can see here, Bree automatically tells us that a worker was created for our job. And this worker then exits once the job is done. The job in our case was this job executed console log, so you can see that it's working fine. I will try to add a cron instead of an interval. So typically a cron will look something like this. To understand this better, we can use an online tool for this. There's this tool provided by Croniter, which lets you create different kinds of cron jobs. You can pass in your own set of values in this syntax, and based on these values you'll get a different cron job. So each of these values have a different meaning. The first one is for minutes, the second one is for hour, the third one will be for day of the month. It starts from 1 and ends at 31. The fourth one is for the month, starts from 1 to 12, which is basically January to December. And the fifth one is for the day of the week. It starts from 0, ends at 6, which is basically Sunday to Saturday. So by default, the cron job that we have set in our example will run for every minute. Now if I change any one of these values, we'll get a different job. So if I change this to 4, this now tells us that our cron job will run at every 4th minute of the hour. So it will still be running at every hour, for every day of the month, for every month, for every day of the week, but it will only be running at the 4th minute because I've changed this to 4 now. If I change the R value to 5, now it will only run at 5:04 a.m. but it will still be running for every day of the month, for every month, for every day of the week. If I change this back to the default value, now this job will run for every minute because this has been set to the default value. But now it will only run after 5 a.m. So it will not run for the time period between 12 a.m. to 5 a.m. But after that, it will start running for every minute. Now, if I make change to the day of the month, say I put in 4, this means that it will now run for every minute on only the 4th day of the month. So the next time it will run will be on 4th December. But on that day, it will run for every minute. If I now change this to 5, it will still be running on the 4th day of the month, but only after it's 5 a.m. So from 12 a.m. to 5 a.m. on 4th day of the month, it will not be running, but after that it will be running for every minute. I hope this makes sense because this is a little complicated and difficult to understand. Now if I set this to 5, this is for the month. If I set this to 5, that means it will only be running in the month of May, but it will still be running for every minute, for every hour, for every day of the month, but only in the month of May. Same for the final one. If I change this to, let's say, 3, this means that it will be only running on Wednesday because the value start from 0 to 6, which is Sunday to Saturday. Now there's a few extra operators here that you can add to your cron job. So we already looked at the star symbol. If I use comma in my cron job, I can add multiple values. So if I add in 5, 6, 7, 8, by separating them with a comma, this means that it will now run at 5th, 6th, 7th and 8th minute of every hour. So if I want like a couple of values, but I don't want to create separate cron jobs for them, I can just use a comma to separate those values. And the job will execute based on those values. If I instead want to pass in a range of values, I can just replace this with a hyphen. It will start from 5th minute of the hour and end at the 8th minute of the hour. But instead of passing in a list of values separated by a comma, I just passed in a hyphen between those values. So now it will run at every minute inside this range. So this will run only for the 5th, 6th, 7th and 8th minute of the 7th hour of the day. Then it will run at 5th, 6th, 7th and 8th minute for the 8th hour of the day, and so on. I can also use a division operator. So if I do this, this basically means that it will run at every 5th minute of the day. So 6:55 is the next time that it will be running. Then it will be running at 7, then 7:05, then 7:10, and so on. I can do this for any other key here if I want to. So if I do 6 over here, this will now run at the 0th minute for every 6 hours of the day. So initially it would have run at 0:00, which is 12 a.m. Then it would have run at 6 a.m. It's already past 6 a.m. so you won't be seeing it over here. Now the next time that it will run will be at 12 p.m. so this will be running after every 6 hours in a day. If I change this to 3, so it will be running for every 3 hours in a day. So starting from 0, then 3, then 6, then 9, then 12 p.m. and so on. So I hope this gave you a basic idea of how a cron job syntax works. You can play around with these values. You can generate random cron jobs if you want. There's even a few examples here, so you can check out these examples. These are the few common ones that you would normally use in your application, so you can check these out. If I click on every minute, we've already looked at it. Every minute is basically this. You can look at those if you want to. So now coming back to our application. So for our application, we'll keep it as it is. We don't need to do anything fancy here. We'll just keep this to the default one. So this will be running for every minute. Now I can also pass in data for individual jobs that I have inside our jobs directory. Since these jobs run in separate worker threads, you can pass in information by using this worker key. And inside this worker key, actually we have a multiple set of options, but we'll be using the worker data property, which is again an object. And inside this, we can pass in whatever data you want. So I'll just pass in name here. And inside this name, I'll just put Kevin. Now this data you can access inside this dummy file because I'm passing it for this dummy job. Only this job here will have access to this worker data. So I can fetch this data that I have passed in inside this worker data property inside this job file. Now right above this job executed console log, I'll just console log my name key that I'll get from this worker data property, and I'll save this. Now if I run this, on every minute of the hour, you should ideally see an executed console log and this name property, which is Kevin. So as you can see here, we get this console log, which is the worker data, which is a name property that we passed in inside this worker data. And along with that, we also get this job executed string. So we have used Bree to create a very basic implementation of a cron job. In the follow-up video, I'll try to create an emailer using this cron job, which will basically send emails at a particular interval. So do subscribe for that. And yeah, I'll see you in the next one.